Charles Malpighi, was a sergeant first class in the U.S. Army Infantry from February 1952 to February 1954.
The period of time from November 1952 to July 1953, I was stationed in Korea on the front line.
Okay, and why did you decide to enlist in the Army in the first place?
Well, there was a draft, and I was at a perfect age. I was just about 20 years of age, and two of my buddies were drafted, same age. So it was just a matter of a short period of time where I would be drafted. So I decided I could enlist for 2 years, and I would get my military time over with. This way, I could start planning my civilian life. And most of the activity then was patrol. You'd go out, try to make contact with the enemy to find out where their exact location was. Once you made contact, contact would be exchange of fire. Then you would leave and you would go back to your battalion, and then you'd report to ranking officers of the activity that took place, what you saw, all different information, how many soldiers could you estimate that were there, the type of weapons they had, things of that sort. And that information they would go over, evaluate it, and to see actually what type of fighting you should continue, if it should be heavy equipment, aircraft, depending on the size, the activity, and the type of fire that they returned. That would be it. So it would be a patrol, make contact, try to get some visual information, and then you report back to the your superiors, and they would take it from there.
Any dangerous moments that, you know, frightened you in any way, or?
Well, sometimes you would have a not air attacks, but they would fire back at us, machine gun, light artillery, weapons of that size and nature. If they got close enough, they would use hand grenades. We did have injuries. We did have some fatalities. And that would be the nature. It was always quick.
Did you miss your family while you were gone?
Oh, yeah. There was you always did miss. You know, you always thought of your family.
Did you lose anyone close, or?
There were a few friends of mine that were wounded. No fatalities. But upon rotation, when I was rotating back to the States, you went from Korea to Japan, from Japan back to the States. There was a large attack by the North and Communist forces, and it was the last big attack before the armistice in July of 1953. And there were quite a few fatalities and naturally injuries from that attack. After that attack, the armistice was declared, and we're just about at the same situation that we are at, where we are now, like we were then, strictly negotiating, talking. I was interviewed by a colonel. It was near the end of my military time, and he tried to persuade me to what they called then re-up, to extend your 2 year time, and they promise you a promotion if you were to re-up, and there were some monetary benefits too involved. But if that life is not what you like, if you're not cut out for it, it's the expression, not your cup of tea.
Wasn't for you.
It's not worth it. No matter how much money or an advancement in rank, you have to like it.
Mm-hmm.
and I just didn't particularly care for it. And I just left.
How did you adjust when you came back to the States? Was it hard to, to get your life back together after being...
No, because I was gone 1 year, July 1952, and I was back August 1953. So it was 13 months. Adjustment wasn't that bad. Maybe because I was young, you can adjust quickly and you can, you know, make the changes quickly without any problems. I was discharged after 2 years and then placed on reserve for 6 years. Within that period of time, you could be activated, called back to service, but I was very lucky that never materialized. So I completed my 6 years of reserve time. They called it inactive reserve, which meant that you don't go to meetings, you don't go on maneuvers, but you're in a reserve. You're there in case needed. Again, I was lucky. They never had to activate me. And so I did a total of 8 years, completed my military obligation, and that was it.